Welcome. So in this hopefully a short lecture, shorter lecture, I want to give an outline or illustration of an interesting placement algorithm for placement that uses the idea of min cut partitioning. Okay, so through an example, I will illustrate the important role of partitioning in the design of a placement algorithm. In fact, as I described in the last lecture, in the previous lecture, there are different kinds of placement is a very important phase of physical design automation, and there are various different kinds of algorithms for placement. In fact, it's a very rich area. Lot of algorithms ideas have been researched upon, and broadly one can classify these placement algorithms as recursive, which are top down, which are based on this kind of partitioning idea. Then there are some algorithms which are iterative, which are based on a very celebrated simulated annealing idea, or a physics based idea of mass springs called force directed placement. There are some very interesting mathematical or linear algebraic approaches which make use of the eigenspectrum and of connectivity information. There is a matrix called Laplacian matrix, which is defined using the connectivity information. Its eigenspectrum, that is eigenvalues and eigenvectors, are used to solve a geometric version of this partitioning problem, and from that combinatorial solution for partitioning is cooked up. So, very interesting classes, different types of placement algorithms have been invented, are being used in the CAD tools. So, for the limited scope of this lectures, as an introduction or overview of some physical design concepts, I would just focus on the partitioning based recursive or top down algorithm. Again, a very natural divide conquer idea, and just want to connect it up with the important role of partitioning. I mean, partitioning can be done manually at the level the designer has kind of indirectly implicitly specified. If designer has specified there is a data path, there is a controller, obviously natural partition would respect that. The controller should be separately layout for a controller should be separately done, layout for a data path should be separately done. If data path further is kind of logically built up using some portions like say fetch unit, decode unit, execute unit, then the partitioning can a manual partitioning or a designer specific partitioning, implied partitioning could induce the placement algorithm to look at the separate logical portions like fetch unit, decode unit in case of a CPU data path to be implemented to be processed for the layout generation separately, and then things can be stitched together. That is a divide conquer approach, and many of the times the partitioning is very natural, is kind of implicit in the design itself, or can be hinted or specified by the designer in a manual way. On the other hand, if there is no clue about, if we are looking at a subsystem and we want to make a good layout of it, we already have a floor plan, we have identified a part of the chip to be used for the layout of a subsystem, sub-design, and that sub-design is still complex enough that we can't get a placement or a routing in an ad hoc fashion very easily. So, we want to further reduce the complexity of this sub-design by partitioning and corresponding area of the chip to be partitioned, and this parts blocks of this sub-design could be separately laid out on the parts of the chip area which is meant for the sub-design, and so on and so forth. So, that is the notions behind that I want to illustrate through an example in this particular lecture. Okay. So, it is going to be based on min cut partitioning approach. It is this discussion is based on an algorithm of Brouwer and an extension of that by Dunlop and Kernighan. Okay. Brouwer, this is at the min cut idea, the top down idea was used Brouwer, like, you know, gave a clear definition of a min-cut based algorithm for placement. And Dunlop-Cunningham extended it to include the so-called terminal propagation idea, which is a very neat, like, nice idea, and without that one would actually not get a good, like, you know, solution. Even though the partitioning can be powerful, the recursive paradigm is obviously intuitive, you know, but the terminal approach is extremely important and helps in the quality of solutions, as we'll see in this example. Terminal propagation, I mean, propagation of terminal. Terminal meaning like input output pads. That information is going to be propagated as we go recursively down in this process of min cut based top down partitioning. Let me recall certain definitions, notions again. Placement, it follows floor planning stage. In the floor planning stage, here chip area is divided of sub designs, sub circuits. Okay, so floor planning is one of the earlier stages, which is where some kind of logical partitioning, manual partitioning would be used, and corresponding the chip area, portions of chip area would be identified, and they are to be earmarked for, like, you know, the layout of sub designs. Okay, and specifically in part placement, we compute or we figure out exact locations of each cell in the sub design. Okay, so we are already working on a part of a circuit and part of a chip. And within that, we want to, like, identify the exact locations where these cells of that particular sub design should be placed. Now, for the moment, like, for this lecture, it will help to kind of forget about the floor planning part. So, we just assume that we had the full design and there is no floor planning, the whole entire area is chip area is available, and we want to divide the chip. We want to use this min cut based approach, so to divide the chip and correspondingly divide the circuit, and independently try and, like, you know, not too independently, but as far as possible in a decoupled way, lay out the sub circuits onto the portions of the chip and then stitch things together in an effective way. Okay. So, we might as well ignore the floor planning issue, and we just assume that we have the full design is being placed on a given chip area. One of the main objectives of placement is minimize area and wire length, total wire length or maximum wire length, and so on so forth. Okay, total or maximum. I mean, you would wonder why total is important. Of course, total is important routing, but in terms of delay, maximum wire length is more important, but like both kind of influence each other. So, it is very difficult to get very clean optimization objective formulations in this area. So, a lot of intuition, domain knowledge has to be used to, and lot of benchmarking has to be done to kind of validate the algorithmic ideas proposed. The core algorithm development can be on an abstracted problem, which may not actually reflect the reality fully, thoroughly, but because of the sophistication of the ideas, one hopes that appropriate, and it will offer a lot of scope for appropriate modification of those ideas to, like, you know, help So, in placement, main objective of placement algorithm is to minimize area and wire length. Wire length, one can question whether the max total wire length is to be minimized or maximum wire length is to be minimized. Now, that is not too clear. Of course, total wire length is going to influence the complexity that a router will have to work with, and on the other hand, the maximum wire length is the main, like, it could be more important from the delay perspective. Okay, but neither of this is going to be a clean, like, you know, optimization objective formulation. So, in fact, it is typically hard to, like, formulate like very correct, accurate objective formulations, and for those, the formulations can be so complex that they would not, one would not be able to like make use of interesting sophisticated mathematical or algorithmic ideas for that. So, lot of emphasis is placed on getting good abstractions and then like modifying, doing the post-processing or like modifying those ideas in a slightly heuristic way for to reflect the practical considerations, practical objectives. Okay, so, we will not worry too much about that. We will roughly say that a wire length is to be optimized. It would mean that total wire length, it could partly mean that maximum wire length is to be minimized. It could also partly mean that congestion of wires in like is to be minimized, whatever. So, here is hopefully this is an example of a circuit. Again, this is from the book like by Kahang, Lienig, Markov and Hu by Springer. The book titled VLSI Physical Design from Graph Partitioning to Timing Closure. Yeah, so this is the netlist, logical netlist, and let us say, yeah, I mean, the objective is of the placement is to could be to lay it out, to create a layout for a one dimensional layout or for a two dimensional layout, and then followed by a router which will also complete a routing and connect things up to this IO pads and give you a layout of the chip. Symbolically, this is how a one dimensional layout will look like. This is how two dimensional placement will look like, one dimensional placement, two dimensional placement. This might look a bit funny, but yes, I mean, a lot of problems can be abstracted to one dimensional placement where you have a row of standard cells, you keep a large number of gates onto that, and then you can go do the something similar with the other rows. So, it is practically useful, but more typically we are going to have two dimensional layout issues, okay, problems to be solved. So, this circuit like which has this 4, 6, 8 gates is to be laid out on a two dimensional placement or one dimensional placement, and you know, depending on how we chose the locations of this A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, whatever, it would give us different wire length estimates or different kind of wiring complexity. Okay. So, this routing can become difficult if this particular placement were far worse. It is not clear whether this is the best placement. Anyway, this is just an example how things would look like, what is the objective of this placement algorithms. So, here is another example. Again, it is not the details are not too important. So, on the left you see one instance of a placement of the same, say not same, some set of cells A to whatever. If there is and there are some wires which are connecting them, if they are placed in this kind of positions, then the wires seem to run in some maybe disorganized but not too congested way. On the other hand, for the same set of cells, if you make a different placement, then the same set of wires, logical connections, they will look far more congested when they are laid out. This is not actual layout or routing of the wires, but even if it abstractly, this is going to indicate that there is more scope, I mean, there is more possibility of a worse, bigger congestion and more difficulty in routing and the quality of the layout. Okay. So, the placement decisions would matter like a lot in getting a good quality layout. Okay. Now, over here, I have an example. Again, the details are not too important here. unlike it's not an example where we are going to work out delays and some numbers. So here is simple netlist. Again, there are whatever six gates, and we have been given this chip area, which seems to have some locations where standard cells can be kept. You know, you do not think in terms of that, but the intention is to kind of identify six positions, six different zones or cell locations where these six gates can be placed in a less cluttered way or in a more efficient kind of, to give us more efficient layout or as efficient as possible. So let's say this an algorithm that is based on this idea of partitioning, which will repeatedly find minimum cut and use it for kind of recursive approach to divide the circuit and correspondingly divide the chip into parts and do this layout generation in placement in divide conquer fashion. Will be given initial cut. Let's say this is the initial cut, cut 1, that separates ABC from DEF. Okay, so this is the circuit with some initial vertical cut, and correspondingly, let's say we have say arbitrarily chosen that one, this part is to be put on the left side and this part is to be put on the right side. Okay, so ABC should be somewhere here and DEF should be somewhere here. Now what next? Okay. So separately we'll be looking at partitioning one particular example of partitioning algorithm, but let's say we have some partitioning algorithm available that works with an abstract representation of this circuit. Okay, abstract representation of this circuit could be like A, B, D, E. Yeah, I mean this could be one of the partitioning algorithm like Kernighan-Lin algorithm, which does not really bother about the electrical significance of wires, source, drivers, directions and so on. Just uses a basic like essence of the topology. Here it is like A is connected to D, B is connected to D, as over here A is node A, gate A is driving gate D, B is driving gate D. Who is driving, who is driven is not being represented here, just some undirected edges. A connected to D, B connected to D, D is connected to E, D is connected to E, C and E are connected, C is driving E in fact. And E and F are connected, E is driving both the pins on F. But essentially we just look at this, we capture the essential information, that is E and C are connected, E and F are connected. Yeah, it does not seem to be very satisfactory, but still this could be one of the starting points for your investigation. So, and the cut one that has been given to us, initial cut, is reflected as something that separates ABC from DEF. So over here in this abstract graph picture, this is the cut one. Okay. Now we first would try to get the best two-way cut. I mean, in general, if the circuit is this graph is very big, the best bipartitioning cutting it into two parts with equal sizes and with minimum number of edges crossing is a hard problem. Okay, so but in this small example, we will be able to work out the best one. So for example, some algorithm will help you figure out that ADB can be on at one side, unlike in the initial partition, and CEF on the other side. Okay, so initial partition was this. Okay. But this turned out to be a poor partition. In fact, there are three edges cutting across. But if we were to use this partition that separates ABD from CEF, that would be the best one, it would cut only one, that's over here. Okay. So, clearly this is the candidate to be laid out on this, this partition is should be used to, like, you know, put this portion over here and lay out this portion of the circuit over here. Should draw it. Okay. We have correspondingly divided this chip into two parts, let us say by a vertical cut line. In the left part, I will attempt to make a layout of this, and the right part, I will attempt to make a layout of this. That seems the very natural way to go further, right. And again, the same, these two sub problems can again be done in the same recursive min cut based up way fashion. Okay. You finding the minimum cut, again dividing this into again using a vertical cut, but maybe more natural would be to like, you know, do alternating kind of horizontal vertical cuts. So, in the next stage, while laying out this onto the left part or laying out this onto the right part, we could use horizontal splitting of this chip area by this horizontal cut line. And obviously, there will be more interesting variations of this, like, you know, adaptations of this. I am not trying to give you the best algorithm, but something that, that explains the idea very simply. Now, we have a problem, I mean, we have two sub problems apparent. One of implementing ADB on one, and one other one of implementing ECF. And this subproblem, this subproblem, and this is the best cut that we have. So, here A, D, somehow we should cook up a good layout for this, we should cook up a good layout for this. This is not a real layout, but I am just saying that this is to be placed here, this is to be placed here, or this is just not full layout algorithm, just a placement algorithm. Now, and of course, this wire will have also have to be placed, this is not placement. Okay. Yet, but we have identified that this is to be targeted for this, this is to be targeted for this, and this wire will have to be correspondingly laid out during the stitching process, during the conquer process. So, recursively we go down further and look at the sub problem on A D B. Again, the best cut will be something like this, this is the best cut, and for E C F the best cut could be this. Okay. It could, there could be other equally good cuts, but let us see this, and based on this we will like we will put mark A and B, A and D to be in the upper half. Previously we had divided this chip into by a vertical cut line, now we are going to divide it using horizontal cut line. A, B and D were, A, D and B were to be on this, and using this, because we have separated this A, D, B circuit into these two part using min cut, I will correspondingly have the split objective, refine objective of making a placement of A, D in this part and B on this side. Okay. But we should have the wiring to complete the picture. And similarly, I say C and E are to be put here and F is to be put here, and E and F. Okay. Now, that has been probably decided, we could have been apparently justified to put C here in the bottom portion and F in the other portion, or this way also. But let us say we had to make some arbitrary decision in the absence of any other hint, any further information. That is what I am going to lead you on to the so called, the idea so called terminal propagation, which is due to Dunlop and Cunningham. Okay. So further, like, you know, we have now four subproblems: the subproblem of AD, placement of AD, the subproblem of placement of B, which is really already solved, and similarly the other non-trivial subproblem is of a layout for or placement for CE. For that, again we divide this and this. So this is going to lead you to this color coding is nothing specific, but now for like, you know, in the absence of any other clue, we could have placed D here and A here, and similarly C here and E here, okay, and we might have placed B over here and F over here, okay. Yeah, I mean, like, the subproblem about doing a placement of AD in this portion could have been further divided until we do not need to go any further, and then we could have maybe decided that D is over here and A is over here. So that solves the problem for the placement of AD in this portion of this chip. The placement of B is arbitrarily decided to be here, placement of F there is no contention, but say a bit arbitrarily we decided to put it here, C and E in this way. But then completing the wiring, when the router completes or we try to estimate the wires, symbolically the wires have to be connected this way, C to E and E to F and D to E, right? Yeah, but does not look like it is too bad, but clearly there is a better looking solution. I mean, and just the example is small enough just to help you see that we have not arrived at, I mean, by doing something arbitrarily, although we have made use of minimum cut, the best cuts at different times, there was a plenty of choice in relative locations, and that might have, you know, you would like to get like to do something extra to get a better solution. So we have this layout. But this is not as good as something that we hope that we could have found A, D, E, C. On the same chip. Okay, this we would have liked to arrive at this even for this simple example. I mean, and so clearly what has led us to this has been a bit of arbitrariness in the choice of like AD is to be laid out here. I mean, it does not matter whether you as far as this sub problem is concerned, it does not matter whether you put D here, A here or the vice versa. Okay, so we had taken some arbitrary decision and that led us to a poorer quality. So we would like this, we would like to be able to make use of some extra information which will help us to some layout of this kind, and that is something that will motivate the extension of min-cut algorithm due to Dunlop and Cunningham. So remark. So, the naive main cut algorithm, which simply relies on finding the best cuts and not really like think about other information, this such naive algorithm does the algos do not consider the location of pins. So exactly what that means, we will try to illustrate through example. Okay, so for example, nowhere in this algorithm that simulation that illustration that we did, we nowhere kind of worried about things like if a cell that is connected to a pad external or like you know or connection to other partition. If we have some information about that this some cell is to be connected to the has to be near a boundary, a particular boundary, then that kind of cell will be placed or should be placed close to appropriate boundary, right? So the location of the pad is going to be used in this decision about placement. So this kind of like idea was not apparently getting used, and Dunlop Cunningham developed this terminal propagation idea to do some justice to this. Okay, as an extent to enhance Brouwer's so let's take the same example and to highlight the main ideas here again you'll have to take things with a bit of pinch of salt. The example is contrived to illustrate some points. We should not try and punch unnecessary holes in that. Like so it is now let me go back to the same example. So we already had found a good cut, okay, for the overall circuit, and that is ADB and F, D and E were connected. So, in terms of placement problem, we kind of committed that this A, D, B will be put somewhere in this left part, and in the right part E, C, F. I am deliberately drawing them in a very like you know congested way just to indicate that I have got the input for this sub problem and got the input for this placement sub problem. So I have the topological information which so I am just going to assume that initially I have no placement information. So I am going to assume that everything is at the center of the near the center of this part, and everything is going to be all this are going to be near the center of this right part of the chip. That is why I have drawn them in a congested way nearby, and there has to be this edge. Okay. Now, while solving this sub problem of getting a placement for the ADB, this is important. So, now we are trying to further solve this left sub problem by splitting it into left top and left bottom. So here it is E, C, F. Okay, this is E, and this is so. Here we recall that ADB was split into for we had for solving the left sub problem, we had to make a partition, get a good partition of ADB, and that turned out to be A, D on one side and B on the other side. Okay. And we decided to kind of put AD on in this left top, this is LT, this is LB, and this is R, right part, which we are not yet touched. Okay. So, now you see that this connection DE is like, you know, compared to this where we did not have any we had not separated ADB in top and a bottom part. Now that we have separated, the connection from D to E will kind of predominantly be here. So, Dunlop-Cunningham's approach is to kind of whenever you have situation of this kind where things get separated, I am not describing it very formally, intuitively, this, the fact that AD has been moved here, how that fact is to be reflected while solving the right sub problem is done with the help of an artificial connection pin called P dash. Okay. This P dash is included here, is kind of introduced here to capture the fact that this net DE is connecting D on this side and E on this side, but the D is already placed in the top left top part. So, P dash is kind of placed at the on this boundary of right side, shared boundary, but in this upper half. Okay. So, with the fixed location of P dash, we are hopefully be while solving the right sub problem, we will be able to decide on the relative placement of E and C more appropriately. Okay. That is the idea. So, P dash is going to be a fixed location over here for the right sub problem. So, this is the way we are kind of propagating some information about, this is not exactly terminal propagation, but in general it is to be used for that. We are propagating some information through terminals, like artificial terminals or artificial pins. Okay. Yes, I missed this D to B. Okay. So, we decided that A and D are going to be in the left top, this is LT, and B is somewhere here, and this is P dash. And this is E, C, F. This is the right sub problem that we have not yet touched, but now we are going to address this. So, now while solving the right sub problem, we are going to pay some attention or give some consideration to this P dash, which is fixed over here. Okay, that is going to be an input, part of the input to the right sub problem. But the main thing is about partitioning this ECF. Okay, so ECF we are going to split it into E and C and F on the other side. But it is going to be clear now that this part is same A. D, P hat, B. So, E and C are going to be brought in the upper part, because if we were to put E and C over here, it would be worse, right? Because it will be worse, because E has to be connected to P hat, P dash, which is in the top part. So, E and C both should be here. In fact, we are not making any relative placement of E and C. We are just deciding whether E and C should be in the top part or in the bottom part, and whether correspondingly F should be here or here. But it is natural that since P dash is connected to E and P dash is fixed to be in the top part, E also along with C should be in the top part. So, this is my R right top and this is my right bottom. So, I have done one level of this problem. So, I have not fully recursively completed that. So, R has been split into RT and RB. Okay. Next, let us say we focus, this is the situation we have AD. Oh, sorry, here I am missing, I should not miss this. So let us say we want to we solve this problem for LT. So LT is to be split into LTL and LTR. So I'm going to split this LT into two parts, left and right part, and correspondingly move, put A and B, place A and B in appropriate portion. So everything is as it is, P dash E C still unplaced over here. Only thing that we have decided is that E and C are going to be here, F is going to be here, B is going to be here, but now we are deciding on the placement of A and D. We are solving this problem, and for that we made a partition. A and D are to be in separate parts, but and now it's clear because of the connection of D with P dash, D has to be over here, okay, and A has to be over here, okay. So you can regard this as being influenced by P dash in some sense. It might be, if you do a recursion in a bit different way, things may or may not, but this is the main idea. One can, in fact, you can have your own variation of Dunlop kerning and algorithm where you make use of this terminal ID, propagation ID in a different way, okay. So, do not assume that I am sticking to exact description of that algorithm. In fact, the idea is to kind of learn this so that you can invent your own or discover your own modifications or figure out alternate approaches and so on. Okay, now this laptop problem is completely solved, right? So LTL, LTR, laptop right is solved. This is left bottom. Now we'll go on to solving this sub problem, and then later on we'll pay attention to this. Okay, now to figure out the placement of B, whether in this or this, again, it will help to think of this as P double dash. Okay. Now, because D is in the right part of left top, it is clear that because of that P double dash is going to be somewhere fixed along this boundary, and because of that B has to be, when B has a choice of being here or here, left bottom right or left bottom left, it would be placed, the algorithm would place it more justifiably over here. So this is my P double dash, and this will force B to be here. We were to decide where B should be, and with the help of this P double dash, we have decided that B should be over here. This is LBL, LBR. So we are basically solving the LB problem, fixing the layout for this left bottom. By recursively dividing things into LBL and LBR, and there is nothing to be done here. And B, when it has a choice, it would, based on the location of P double dash, it is connected to B, will be more logically over here. Okay, so this has solved the left side problem completely. Now, similarly, the right side problem. Okay, now let us focus on this R top problem, and this will take us to this is fully done with the help of P double dash, this is with the help of this. Now EC has to be split in two parts, E and C. Whether E should be here or E should be here, C should be here or C should be here, that is again going to be influenced by P dash. So E is more logically here and C is over here, okay. Moment E and C get separated this way, the connection to F, gets like biased towards in the upper portion. Okay. Earlier we had drawn this connection between E and F to be like this, but now I will show it in slightly more biased fashion, and I will call this cut this point on the cut line connection as an artificial cut line point called P triple hat. Okay. So, now it is clear what is the purpose of this. Just the way P double dash induced this B to come on this side rather not on this side, P triple hat is going to induce F to be placed here, not here. Okay. So, from here clearly what we are going to get is A, D, B, this was with the help of P double dash, this was with the help of P dash, E, C, F. Okay. This is the best layout that we are hoping to get. So, there is some role of, clearly there is some evidence of role of terminal propagation. It could be exactly like same as what Dunlop Kerning has suggested, or it could be your own variation of that. So, I believe like the main point has been brought out, that is with the help of the extra information about the terminals, initially there could be the fixed location that this particular input has to come from outside world, it could, which is some other subsystem which is laid out on the left side. So, that input is coming through one of the pads on the left side of the chip, and similarly something else could be on the right side or top side. Based on that, the placement of at some stage in this top down min-cut based placement, the locations, certain decisions will be helped by this information, and we will be able to cut down on the ambiguity, and because of which one might get misled in the later stages of the algorithm. And this will help, as this example obviously has been contrived to show the effect of this modification, and we have arrived at this good answer compared to the bad answer that we did not like over here. Okay. We had without use of any terminal propagation idea, we could have, just using the min cut, we could have arrived at this, but instead we have managed to arrive at this kind of solution. Just confirm that it is. So, this is what we have arrived at, exactly what we wanted, okay, with the help of P dash, P double dash and P triple dash. Let me see anything more. Yeah, you can, this example is illustrated a bit differently, as well as there is another example that you would find in the book, just to confirm your ideas, your understanding and learn more about it from the book. I have avoided to discuss it in a very formal, rigid way, just trying to focus on the highlights, the important essence notions. Thank you.